Hey, welcome back in today's video, T-Series. How did it topple PewDiePie? How did it conquer YouTube? The story is actually a little bit darker than you thought. And are they subbotting? Are they cheating to get there? We're gonna take a look at some of these popular conspiracy theories and see if they're true, as well as explain to you exactly the real reason why T-Series has came so far. The rate of T-Series getting subscribers is something like around about 10 subs per second continuously, which doesn't make any sense. And still, the low rate of views, at least for the number, should be way higher. Low rate of likes to dislikes, low rate of comments. What else could it be other than subbotting? Another thing is that when YouTube went out worldwide, Social Blade tweeted this. Interesting, YouTube is down worldwide, but T-Series is still getting subscribers. Now, this was a weird happening because though no one else could be subscribed to, T-Series could be. Now, I looked into this rumor and it turns out it wasn't down everywhere. America isn't the world. That pretty much ended that controversy. The next thing was this. If you create a YouTube channel in India, are you automatically subscribed to T-Series? Well, I found this really cool YouTuber, Timeworks, and he answers that question.
I downloaded a VPN. Now, for those of you who don't know what a VPN is, basically you can change your IP address so it looks like you're somewhere you're not. I'm in Canada, but as you can see, it looks like I'm in India. To T-Series, the YouTube channel. Okay, we are not subscribed. Guys, this just in, we are not subscribed to T-Series.
So there you have it. That answered, there is no auto subscription. But if there's no cheating going on, how is it possible? Well, to first understand the answer to this question, you must understand T-Series. The bootleg baron. T-Series is no stranger to music privacy. It is now using that familiarity to hunt down those who filches music. Some will say that robber baron is an appropriate metaphor for T-Series, India's largest music company. As critics point out, it's an entity that got there by selling millions of audio cassettes for which it didn't own the copyrights to, by exploiting ambiguities in the copyright law. That means that they found ways. There are differences within the Indian copyright laws and the American copyright laws. We will get into that really soon. But when 19-year-old Bhushan Kumar took over the reins at T-Series months later, the future was uncertain. The company's street smart founder had just been murdered. The group had stretched itself thin by diversifying into unrelated areas. Having built its fortune by sidestepping copyrights, T-Series had lost the trust of most people in Bollywood. And ironically, the privacy demon had turned on the company that had become a large-scale owner of copyrights. Wow, who would have thought that this was born of blood? So the main difference between the copyright laws in India and America is that theirs is called fair dealing, where ours is called fair use. And the differences can be manipulated very easily. As you can see, they're only, they have three main avenues of whether to figure out if it's legal or not legal, and it's private or personal use, including research, criticism or review, reporting of current events and current affairs. And so you can see how easily this can be tweaked and manipulated. And oh buddy, does T-Series, this channel, actually do this? And I'm not saying it's wrong, I'm saying it's pretty clever the way they've been able to work around the laws to get their agenda fulfilled in the long run. Things to know about Gulshan Kumar murder case. He was actually a very humble man. He was very nice. He was really pretty much nice to everyone. And the country took a big hit when he was murdered. He was murdered by an actual Indian mafia, the Crime Syndicate D or something like that. August 12th, 1997, Gulshan Kumar, owner of T-Series, is shot dead when coming out of a temple. The assailants had pumped 16 bullets, killing him on the spot. Why was Gulshan Kumar assassinated? Gulshan Kumar was assassinated to show that if you didn't pay homage to the underworld, you will be killed. Just to prove their power, a person like him was killed, and when he was returning from a temple that he helped build. So when his son Bushin took over, things were not looking good. Everything was pretty stretched thin because they were diversifying in so many different subjects. So desperation compelled Kumar to take a look at new business models. T-Series quickly saw the writing on the wall. He set his eyes on the model of publishing and licensing. Anything that had anything to do with music in India was directly tied to T-Series, creating a sort of monopoly. But oh my god, did that monopoly ever grow? We own copyrights to over 100,000 songs, which we've accumulated since the 1980s, says Neeraj Kilian, who looks after T-Series mobile and international ventures and superheads the legal strategy. This gives us 60% of the market for contemporary music. Holy crap. So music videos and song visuals from Bollywood are another segment that T-Series is targeted. Today, the company owns copyrights to over 30,000 music videos and makes money every time someone watches a song on TV or the internet. Woo! The company is now gunning for websites that allow music sharing. At the core of the issue lies T-Series' assertion that its music videos, songs being made available on such websites lead to a loss of potential revenues. And they were very serious about this, as you will not believe the amount of lawsuits that they have went after. They've been in lawsuits with actually YouTube, MySpace, you name it, and there's a lawsuit for it. So Indian budget smartphone market has been exploding, and you get internet access as cheap as $2 a month. T-Series is mainly a channel for promoting movies, so any Indian that is even remotely interested in movies subs to them. So this got me thinking, Mr. Kalyan was the president of T-Series, heads mobile. Let's look into that. So I ran into this article that talks about mobile phones and automatic subscriptions called VAS products, meaning that people that get phones are being automatically subscribed to certain things. Better late than never, the Telecom Regulatory Authority, TRAI, has issued directions for telecom service providers on provision of value-added contents. The directions intend to check the activations of VAS products, especially on prepaid mobile connections, without the customer's explicit consent. The TRAI also mentioned that it has been receiving complaints from consumers about providers renewing VAS products even when the available balance is in the customer's account is insufficient. So basically, so they are getting subscribed to contents and services that they didn't initially pick, and it's their bank accounts are going negative even if they don't have the money in there, which is really weird. Intellectual property rights, IPR, was the next frontier for the music industry to be conquered, was what son Bhushan Kumar instinctively understood. In fact, he bet on to create a monopoly that's quite unparalleled in the RS750 core Indian music industry. It is sheer irony that the bulwark of his father's strategy was based on loopholes in Indian copyright law, while his son is using the same IPR to safeguard his monopoly. So again, they are using loopholes in laws that are different from American to Indian in order to advance their company. But it's legal there. They're not doing anything wrong, and it seems like India is really loving it. Millennials structure the significant portion of the gathering of people that the music and film industry in India concentrate on. Most millennials are online constantly, catching their consideration on the web assumes the fundamental part of choosing the achievement of a tune or a motion picture. Basically meaning that if they're a celebrity in that area, if they're looking to grow, if they're looking to get into the industry, T-Series is their go-to. So they have these popular pop stars and actors that are basically promoting and just intertwined with T-Series. So everybody in the whole nation, of course, is gonna go for it. If you haven't realized but now that T-Series is actually a monopoly, and they control TV, film, mobile phones. They basically are YouTube in India. So you can't really compare PewDiePie versus a whole nation. You're about to see why. So what are some examples of some value-added services? Well, one of the main ones that stuck out to me was music subscriptions. One of the popular ones that can provide a source of large revenue, especially in the Middle East where markets are saturated, Virgin Media subscription provides a promising proposition to consumers in an area that has not seen the results that had been previously thought. Both Virgin Media and Telenor WIP offer to provide a partnership to mobile companies and consumers, an alternative to piracy. An alternative to piracy. Both subscriptions are in line with industry trends towards entertainment. If you haven't been keeping up and you're confused, this is what's going on. They're not subbotting. They're not automatically subscribing to anyone. What this is they've taken advantage of copyright laws since the very beginning. They are literally suing everyone. They've done it. You can put in the name Super Cassettes Industries Private Limited and put lawsuits, search lawsuits, anything to do with them, you will see that they have sued everyone. No one goes up against these guys in India because they literally are a monopoly. They own about 90% of all telecommunications, that's phones, TV, they own everything. So basically, they are the India YouTube. This is why you can't compare PewDiePie as an individual to this company that's a conglomerate of TV, music, telecommunications with value-added services. You can see that they're going to keep growing because they are a monopoly. But I'm going to put in the description the links to everything that I've read and talked about. There's so much more that I could go into, but I really don't want to make this video super long. I just wanted to inform you good people of exactly why and how T-Series has dominated. And they will continue to dominate. So I hope you slap a like on this video and as interesting as this is, there's always something that's more interesting to me. That's right, you guessed it. I want to know what you think. So why don't you go ahead and leave your creative and or interesting responses in the comment box below.
Thumbs up for those likes.
As always, brothers and sisters, I will see you in the next video. So yeah, man, I think it's cool, you know, T-Series, they have this business mindset and they're doing all this stuff. It's really sad that how Gulshan was murdered, and it seems like he was such a good dude. But I want to use this video as my first dedication to my new Patreon. That's right, I have Patreon. The link is in the description, and it's really fun to have. I don't know much about it, but it's a learning thing, learning curve that we'll learn together. So if you want to support the new things that I'm doing for the channel, I want to do the vlog series next year where we go and do paranormal exploring, hunt down urban legends, all these cool things like that. And it's going to cost a little bit more in production. It's going to take a little bit more time. If you want to support things like that, then go over to the Repzilla Patreon. It's got all the tiers that you can have and everything like that. I have 3 Patreons right now, but I've not really ever promoted it. So you can be one of the first to get in there, because the link is going to be below, and I will see you there, because it's fun talking with the 3 people I already do have, and I expect because I know that you're repping. If you're not repping, you're great. And how do you become a member of the Rep Squad? All you gotta do is subscribe, notifications turn on, be in the comment section to every single video, because I'm going to be here. Greg the Cat's going to be there, and the rest of the Rep Squad community as well. And I expect to see you there too, because this channel loves you. Woo!